full of Savior, we trust the living and friend. Whoever called out the light of God, rescue the souls of men. Oh, rescue souls. Lord, and comforting keeper, speeding we long to him round. You offer hope in our hearts, hopeless lost our ways. Oh, hopeless we lost the way. You are the one that we
Sabbath, everyone. It's nice to see all of you today. I wasn't expecting today to have a near full church. Usually, when the elders are preaching, less people coming, because they used to have elder every Sabbath, but looks like today is reversing, which I don't know. Ah, you came for singing. Well, I didn't put my name over there. I don't know how you name
it. You solo.
Yes. Even today, I suppose not be. Every time when I'm doing this, I suppose to replace someone. We supposed to have Brother Dylan, but Brother Dylan has went back to his country with his family. But I knew this most hours ago. I've been trying to find the replacements about a few weeks ago, but apparently everyone was busy, everyone had something else, and I said myself, okay, that means it's your time. And sometimes you don't want, but God needs you. And today I would like to open our scriptures in John chapter 1, and we like to read with verse 29. Sorry. John chapter 1, verse 29. Whoever is ready.
The next day, John saw Jesus coming toward him and said, "Behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world."
Amen. Thank you. Now let's bow our head to have a word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, I'd like to thank you for this opportunity to share the words today. Father, I'm just a vessel in your hands. I'm asking you to pour your Holy Spirit in me. And the word what we deliver to not be my own, but to be your own. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Today we're looking to talk about lambs, about the Lamb of God, about the Jesus Christ. These days, I'm traveling a lot from Ashford to Canterbury and always through the country lanes. And now is the season when the little lambs start coming, you know. And every time when I'm passing through, I'm looking to them. I see them small, jumping all the way around. They are so gorgeous, which I'm looking to, even sometimes I'm looking to park my car and go in over there and play with them. They are so, so nice and so quick, cute. And myself as well, I was grew up in with my grandmother. I didn't have lambs, but I had from the goats. How you call them, the little goats?
Many goats.
Huh?
Kids.
Kids, many goats. Yeah. And I had that once. And I remember every time when the goat has delivered babies, and I was playing with them. I was so nice until the day when we're supposed to sacrifice and eat it. And my heart always was trembling and suffering. Why are we supposed to kill these animals? Why are we supposed to eat my friends? And later on, I understand. Not is the reason why I become a vegetarian and pro-vegetarian, but now I understand why it's this kind of stuff, because I grow up. But they are so cute. Yes, they are so cute. And the little lambs are so cute. I said, I would like to spend a whole day with them and just to play with them. And sometimes I can't understand how God chooses these animals to die for us. And the first sacrifice what was started, it was started in Genesis 3 and verse 21. If I would like again to ask your assistance. Thank you. He didn't say about any sacrifice, but he said the Adam and Eve, it was dressed in the skin of animals. Later on, we can deduct, and we know by Noah, everyone was vegetarian. After Noah, we started becoming meat eaters as well. That means the only reason to be killed that animals was for sacrifice. And as well, we see the continuation of sacrifice doesn't finish in there. It was continue because we see more clearly the sacrificial of the lambs in Israel. Yeah, this is where they started killing the lambs. But the sacrifice of the lambs was established on a time of Adam and Eve. And I would like to, as well, to read Genesis 4, verse 4.
Genesis 4, verse 4.
And Abel, for his part, brought of the firstlings of his flock, their fat portions. And the Lord had regard for Abel and his offering.
Amen. That means Abel has bring a lamb for sacrifice again. Yeah. That means we see the continuation. Them parents was dressed up in the skin of animal. he was bringing the lamb as a sacrifice. And later on, we see Abraham as well doing this. Even he take his son as a sacrifice. Later on, we can see it. But we will discuss later. But the continuation of sacrifice was till Moses has been established how to do it, the order. And I would like, because the lambs wasn't sacrificed only for Easter. They were sacrificing during of a year. Because, for example, if you sin something, you could come with a lamb to the priest and give it for your sin. But I would like you more special to talk about the lamb in the Easter period. And we can find this in Exodus chapter 12. Exodus chapter 12, and verse 3 to 7.
Speak to all the congregation of Israel, saying, on the 10th of this month, every man shall take for himself a lamb and according to the house of his father, a lamb for the household. And if the household is too small for the lamb, let him and his neighbor next to his house take it according to the number of persons, according to each man's name. You shall make your count for the lamb.
Seven. 3 to 7.
The lamb shall be without blemish, the male, first year. You may take it from the sheep or from the goats. Now you shall keep it until the 14th day of the same month. Then the whole assembly of the congregation of Israel shall keep it quiet. And they shall take some of the blood and put it on the two doorposts and on the lintel of the houses where they eat.
Thank you. Thank you. This is instructions about the lamb. You know, it's interesting because this lamb is supposed to be held 14 days in the house before it was supposed to be slain. This is why I said to you from the very beginning about the lambs, what I see on lambs. How cute they are. And you know, you keep it at home. The children are playing with it. You are attached with this as well, because you're supposed to not take in the unwanted lamb. You're supposed to take it the blemish with no any defects on it. The most beautiful lamb, and keep it in your house until the day of Easter. Because God, when he established this, didn't want to establish these animals needs to be killed forever and forever, was trying to point on something. And that something is the Lamb of the God who came in this world, which is Jesus Christ. And it's interesting because this Lamb wasn't talked only in the time when he came. He was talking about a long time ago. And in Isaiah 53, in that chapter, is amazed that this chapter, because when before we're going to read, when I first time read this chapter, I was shocked. Because in my childhood, I saw some videos about Jesus Christ, how he was dying. But when I was read this one, and I saw so accurate describing, I said, I cannot believe how God told to his people 100 years ago how Jesus will be suffering. And the verse which I would like to speak about is verse 7. Yeah, whatever you said, ready?
He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He was led as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before his shearers is silent, so he opened not his mouth.
Amen. We see the description. It said, like a lamb. God is describing him as a lamb. This is why when I was a child, when I saw, I said to you, I didn't have lamb, but I had little baby goats. And they were so cute, and the time when I supposed to slay them. And my heart was so trembling, so sad, because they need to die for our stomach. But here, the animals supposed to die because we are sinful. The problem has been started from very beginning, yeah, the sin. But Jesus, when he came, didn't came just to die for no reason. He came because Adam and Eve has been sinful first of all. And we know from the first description, when we know the Adam and Eve, when they sinned, it's interesting because God didn't abandon them. God has came first of all to them, give even the sacrifice, and that sacrifice supposed to reflect to Jesus. And this is and them, they was forgive because they accept that sacrifice of God, what has been given. And another thing, what is interesting, because they supposed to dress up that skin all the time, because this was the new covering. Because remember, when they was sin, they was realized they are naked, and God has covered in the sacrifice what was made for them. And basically, they was covered now about the nakedness, but they was wearing the sacrificial for them. And this is why God has been established this before he created the world. Because the plan of salvation has been created, has been done before God has been looking to establish a new world. He knew we will sin. He knew about the things what will happen, but because he loves the human being and his creations and everything what he is, he made us and he gave the lamb. In my country, we celebrate Easter, but we have a different ways how we celebrate it, because our country is more predominantly Orthodox Church. In our Easter, on our food, main food is lamb, and it's something like, it's like not a Easter without lamb, like it's no turkey without Christmas. It's no Christmas without turkey here. I don't know what kind of meat are you using in England, but I haven't seen people so fussing about lambs. And in Romania are more than like hundreds of thousands of lambs are killed every Easter because people wants to do it. And as well, in Romania is a tradition, because every year for 14 days, for day when is Easter, to until the Jesus is going to heaven, 40 days, every day they don't say good morning, or they don't say hello, they said Christ resurrected, and your answer needs to be yes, true resurrected. And this is how always they're trying to interact between them. And if you don't respond that, they've been offended. How you don't respond it to me like this? Which in England, I haven't seen this kind of practice. But this is in our country. This is in our country. But my point is, people for Easter they concentrated about more resurrection of Christ, which, yes, is important. But Christ didn't come to resurrect only. The most important thing what Christ came is to die for us. He didn't came because he wanted or he was forced. He came because he's supposed to die and supposed to end up all of his animals slaughtered. Imagine if I said to you, in my country, is hundreds of thousands of lambs every year is killed in, and this is only once a year. Imagine in Israel was killed millions of lambs every year. But God said he wants to finish this sacrifice of lambs and to establish the true lamb, the true lamb. And which in John chapter 20, chapter 1, verse 29 said, this is the Lamb of God. This is the Lamb of God. It's not other lambs. It's not anything. And it's interesting because this lamb was blameless. This is why we need to compare the Easter lamb with Jesus Christ. He didn't have any sin. Because this is the meaning of a lamb, to bring it blameless, is to represent Jesus. Is to represent Jesus. And Jesus itself has no committing sin, but he decided to die for me and for you. I know we probably heard this story many times ago. Jesus has died for us because of our sin, and we have this kind of practice. We have 4 times per year communion service, and during the communion service, we're still reminding about his death. But this step is much more deeper. Because I want you to bring it again into the Garden of Eden. Imagine God sitting with 2 adults, and instead to condemn them and kill them or leave them to die, he decided to show them the plan of salvation through that lamb. Probably we can't realize that because we are not in that situation. We've never been put in that situation, you know, in situation where we need to die. And instead you to die, that will die, or I will die. We haven't put it that one. And this is why for us, Jesus today is so easy. And sometimes we forget he died for our sins. Yeah. And we are happy because he resurrected, but he could choose to not die, but he died. And the problem wasn't he wanted to be resurrected. He knew he would resurrect. He knew the plan, everything, all of the plans. He knew when he will complete the mission, the Father will establish his life back. But the problem wasn't that he didn't came for resurrected. He came for dying for us, for me and for you. And as well, I would like you to illustrate a story about two teens, 2 brothers teens. They grew up in a neighborhood in America. And in that neighborhood, it was a bad neighborhood where they used to do a lot of things during our young thing. But one of the brother has decided to continue that path to the criminal with the criminal people. But another one has found Jesus in his life. And and he became a pastor. Till one day, when he heard his brother, he's been prosecuted and he is condemned to the death penalty. I know Sister Campbell have twins, but they are not 100% identically. One is taller, one is shorter, and they look same, but them, these brothers, they look very, very well. And sometimes I had some colleagues in my class where I didn't know which were and who are there, because you couldn't find anything which you can identify. And because they wear the same clothes, they wear the same shoes. And these brothers was look so identical. And when he heard his brothers in the prison and he's condemned on a death penalty, he went to visit him. Just a day before he was supposed to be killed. I don't know if he's still in America, these kind of things, if he's anymore. Yeah, he's still. And he went and he spoke with his brother. And he said, brother, in my life, I had a second chance to change my life. We grew up together on these criminal things, but in my way, I was decided to follow Jesus. And I knew if I will die, I'm going to heaven. But you don't have the second chance. But I want to offer you the second chance today. I want to make you an offer. The offer is to change the clothes, and I will die for you. The brother, when he listened to this, he said, no, it's impossible. You haven't done nothing. You supposed to die for me? Yes, brother, but you can have a time now to change your life. Because till now, you didn't think about your life. And now is the time to change your life. They was crying together, hugging each other, kissing. And in the end, his brother has accepted to change the role. But the pastor brother said to his criminal brother, said, brother, but promise to me, you're not using the second chance again. And he said, yes, I will promise to you. They saw the clothes, and the brother who was pastor now was a condemned, and the brother who was condemned now is taking the pastor role. And the day came, the execution came, and his brother died instead of his place. And the pastor, the condemned brother, he started using his life, his identity. And the congregation, when he started preaching, they feel something differently because he started preaching very powerful. He continued the mission of his brother, but more powerful than his brother itself. He is using the second chance, what has been given, because he understands, because somebody died instead of him. This is why I said to you from the very beginning, if we are understanding the lambs, what was sacrificed from the very beginning, and Jesus Christ who died for us, probably today, our second chance, what we have, wasn't the same. The transformation is coming when you understand truly the signification of the death of Christ. It's it's not coming when you just becoming a regular member and you visit. And even if you are baptized in the church, this is, doesn't mean you are converted. But the conversion is when you understand somebody died for yourself, when you put in faith, like that brother, which I said to you, he had only one more day and he's supposed to be dying. This is when you understand your situation. I know when we put in face to the death, we would like to do everything just to enjoy more time. But Jesus Christ didn't give only one day. Didn't give only 1 year. Didn't give 10 years, 100 years. He gave us an everlasting life. And he accepted to die in our place. Probably today, you're thinking, no, Christ didn't die for me. Probably you're thinking, now it's too easy that to accept Christ as my death penalty. Probably don't think, because you are young, you think you have another 50, 100 years ahead. And you not realize that. But I want to say to you, the Christ is most important thing in your life, what you can discover. And you, member of this church, if you receive the Christ in your life, and you understanding one day, and you understand one day, Christ has died in your place, this was your second chance. Please, my brother, don't waste it. Don't waste the second chance. Because the condemnation is coming again. Imagine that brother was continued to be a criminal, not becoming a pastor. He's lost the chance and as well the reputation of his brother as well. But Christ didn't care about his reputation, because in the Bible, we can see Christ, he said, he God himself is untaking his clothes and becoming as a woman like us, a slave for us. Because he wants you to be saved. God doesn't take care about his reputation, but he wants you to be saved. It's not like another boss which is standing on a chairs and said you need to do X, Y, Z things and waiting results. This is not the God what I know. But this is the Christ which I know in the story which I said to you, who wants to replace me from the death penalty. Today is the day where we can renew with our commitment and said, God, Father, please forgive me. Please forgive me because I waste my second chance. Please remind me because you died for me. I'm supposed to be in that seat of condemnation, but you replace me. Please forgive me. And I want you to give me a new heart. And if you didn't receive Christ in your day, and you didn't receive his sacrifice, I'm asking you, I'm pleasing you to accept Christ. Because the second chance is given for free. Like the brother has accepted to change the clothes, this is what Christ wants to do with you today. He wants you to be free of sin. Today, my appeal to you, my brothers and sisters, is let's understand the true meaning of sacrifice of Christ. Ellen White said we need to reflect daily about his sacrifice, daily. Not once a quarter, not once a year, the day, and when we understand that true meaning, this is when we'll be transformed every day. I'm hoping in one day I will see you not on condemned seats, but on the mercy seats, sitting next to Jesus. Probably sometimes we didn't understand how God has been done so miraculous things in our lives, and he's decided to die for me a sinner. Who am I supposed to be condemned on this world? Well, I'm nobody of this world. He's decided to be. And the true signification of a death needs to be in your heart. In your heart, where it needs to be changed, where it needs to be transformed. God wants us to understand his sacrificial. Don't not become as a Jewish, where every year they slaughter a lamb, and they slaughter it again, and they slaughter it again, and they slaughter it again. Nothing has been happening in their heart. Let the real Easter to becoming part of our life. Yes, we are happy because Jesus was resurrected. But I feel more regretful because he died for me. He died for me. But I'm happy because he died for me, and as well he released me from the sin. As the other brother said, please, brother, don't do it. Don't do this change. This is what you need to understand as well. Please, because Jesus is with you now. He wanted to change the clothes of you. He said, you need to please him. Please don't change the clothes of you. I don't want you to die for me. But he decided to die. Today you can renew your commitment, or you can hand over your life. Before we go into the song service, I would like to ask you, who wants to renew their lives and who wants to surrender their lives to Jesus and to accept his sacrifice, to raise his hand? Let's pray together. Dear Heavenly Father, I'd like to thank you for this wonderful message, what you've been giving to us, the message of deliverance of our sin, the message of freedom from our life, the message of a second chance, what you've been giving to us. Father, please forgive us for our sins. Please forgive us for the second chance, what we wasted for. Father, make us to understand the true meaning of your sacrifice. Make us to understand who died for us and for what has been done for us. Father, as well, I'm praying for the people who haven't accepted your sacrifice in their life. We ask you to work on their hearts to understand the true meaning of sacrifice. Faith needs to understand because the condemnation is next to them. They can close their eyes every day, any day. You don't know what. They don't know what is happening. May them to understand, to accept your offer to die in place of them. Make them to accept your life in them. Father, we ask you to bless our children as well, because the time when it's coming to accept you as a Lord and a Savior on them life, make them to be open hearts and willing to accept, and as well to understand the importance of your sacrifice. Father, please accept in our human prayers. In Jesus' name I'm praying. Amen.